The global elite descends on Davos in Switzerland this week for the 54th World Economic Forum. The summit of 120 economies opens on Monday on the backdrop of heightened geopolitical tensions from Ukraine to the Middle East. It's also happening amid the expected shift in central banks' interest rate policies, the emergence of artificial intelligence, and pressing climate issues. Investors will be keeping an eye out on speeches by Chinese Premier Li Keqiang, European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, and Argentina's new president Javier Milei. The U.S., meanwhile, is to be represented by Secretary of State Antony Blinken. No word yet if the Philippines is sending a delegation to the summit. A Davos survey of top economists has warned of a precarious year for the world's economy. More than half of those polled see weaker global economic conditions, specifically in Europe. Growth, meanwhile, is expected to either be moderate or stronger in the U.S., as well as in China and in other parts of Asia. Now, ahead of the forum's opening, hundreds of protesters braved the chilly weather to demand more action from world leaders on environmental issues. As the U.S. and its allies ramp up action to stop Iran-backed Houthi rebels from attacking ships in the Red Sea, China is steering clear of the battle. Bloomberg analysts believe Chinese leader Xi Jinping does not see much to gain from taking a stronger position in the Red Sea issue, similar to his approach to the Russia-Ukraine war. The analysts add Xi is happily sitting on the sidelines as the West fights the Houthis, stoking anti-American sentiments in parts of the Middle East while portraying himself as a neutral arbiter. The world's second largest economy has also rebuffed a U.S.-led task force to provide security for vessels transiting the Red Sea. But this could potentially impact the cost of Chinese imports of energy. China's oil imports from the Middle East accounted for 46% of the country's total crude imports last year. Taking a look now at futures in Europe, they are poised to open in positive territory. Several economic data are due out today, which could move markets. That included Germany's full-year 2023 GDP report, as well as industrial and trade numbers from the Eurozone. Stateside now, Wall Street is closed for the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday, so futures are pointing flat. Asian markets are trading mixed as investors digest the weekend elections in Taiwan. Now, Taiwan's ruling Democratic Progressive Party pulls off a historic third-straight presidential victory. Investors in the region are monitoring how China, which claims the self-ruled island as its own, would move forward. Beijing's top diplomat had already asserted Taiwan's independence will never be possible. Wang Yi added, no election results will change Beijing's stand that Taiwan is part of China. Beijing has never ruled out the use of force to bring Taiwan under its control.
Taiwan has never been a country, not in the past, and certainly not in the future. Taiwan independence has never been possible. It has not been possible in the past, and it will never be possible in the future. Anyone on the island of Taiwan who wants to pursue Taiwan independence or split China's territory will be severely punished by history and law.
Taiwan elected Lai Ching-te as its new president, shrugging off warnings by China his victory would lead to more tensions. Also on top of investors' minds, China's fourth quarter gross domestic numbers, which will be out on Wednesday, and Japan's December inflation figures due out on Friday. Taking a look now at major stock indices here in Asia, we're seeing Japan's Nikkei 225 leading Monday's rise, staying at the 35,000 level. Chinese markets, meanwhile, are mixed after Beijing's central bank left its medium-term policy loans rate unchanged. For numbers that matter, this Monday, something on the world's richest. An Oxfam study reveals the five wealthiest men on the globe more than doubled their fortune to $869 billion in the past 4 years. The charity's findings were made public ahead of the opening of the WEF in Davos. It identified the persons as Tesla CEO Elon Musk, Louis Vuitton's Bernard Arnault, Amazon's Jeff Bezos, as well as Oracle co-founder Larry Ellison and the Oracle himself, Warren Buffett. Oxfam notes these people were richer by $3.3 billion than they were in 2020. That is despite crisis after crisis, including the COVID pandemic. A jarring difference, though, Oxfam says, that since the same year, nearly 5 billion people worldwide have grown poorer. The anti-poverty group has since renewed its calls for government to break up monopoles or monopolies and impose taxes on excess profit as well as wealth.
The British Chamber of Commerce in the Philippines looking forward to working with new Finance Secretary Recto. BCCP Executive Director Chris Nelson says the chamber is banking on Recto's connections with the Legislative Department to help pass key measures, including the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act. Meanwhile, the group is also on board efforts to amend economic provisions of the Philippine Constitution.
We have always said we would consider that and look and support it for the economic provisions. Those provisions for the viewers and everybody else is the negative investment list. It also requires to the 60-40, which obviously limits the foreign investors to 40%. I think overall you could do it piecemeal, but of course the charter change would bring in a much quicker response. And in that context, I would say, we are always advocating to companies to come to do business in the Philippines. It's an attractive market, but it's also a gateway to Southeast Asia. And anything that can move and further liberate the economy will be supported. One specific legislation which we also support, that's on cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is going to be critically important. It's